Hello everyone, this is teacher Rodrigo and this is our English video class for 9th grade phase 3 week 9, okay? English video class for 9th grade phase 3 week 9, okay? Today we are studying the following topic: leisure time activities, music, movies, book, games, sports, okay? Leisure time activities, music, movies, books, games, sports, okay? Attention that we are in unit number 5. Si todavía no la ha hecho, please elaborate the unit number 5, okay? Si todavía no la ha hecho. Okay, now let's have a general overview, una vista general of what we are going to study. First, we have a picture here, una foto, yes, picture. What do you usually do when you go to the park, okay? Las cosas que la people usually do when goes to the park, yes? Now, leisure time activities, vocabulary, okay, we will practice some vocabulary here. Later on, we will practice collocations here, practiquemos colocaciones, which are ways to speak, I mean, manera de hablar in English, certain ways to collocate words so that they don't change, okay, se colocan las words, las frases de cierta manera y no se cambian, they don't change. It's a way to speak, es una forma de hablar en English. After that, we have a little practice here, according to this picture. Regarding this picture, vamos a ver qué es lo que cada uno dijo está haciendo en su leisure time, okay? Now, let's see. Let's start. Activation. Here. ¿Cuáles actividades sueles realizar cuando vas al parque? Haz una lista en tu cuaderno. Attention, make a list. Haz una lista en tu cuaderno. You have to make a list of activities that you should do, that you do when you go to the park, okay? Here we have, for example, I usually fly kites. Yes, I usually fly kites. Yes, fly kites. The other is I take my dog for a walk. I take my dog for walk, llevo al perro de paseo. I usually play the guitar. I usually walk, yes. I usually rest, descanso, for example, okay. So make a list, haz una lista of the activities that you do when you go to the park. Now, presentation. Leisure time es lo mismo que decir free time, okay? Attention to that. Leisure time es lo mismo que decir free time. Ambos términos se refieren al tiempo libre, free time. Para describir las actividades que haces en tu tiempo libre, tienes que enriquecer tu vocabulario. A continuación, te presentamos las actividades más comunes que realizamos en nuestro tiempo libre, okay? So these are the most common, okay? There are more, there are many more activities that we usually do in leisure time, but these are the most common, okay? Listen and repeat. Dance. 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 Dance salsa. Dance rumba. Dance tango. Okay? Dance. Dance. Next. Play chess. Play chess. Play chess. Watch TV. Watch TV. Watch TV. Play sports. Play sports. Play sports. Read. 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 Play video games. That's my favorite. Play video games. Play video games. Play video games. Play the guitar. Play the guitar. Play the guitar. Okay? Here you can say play piano, play the guitar, play the cello, whatever, yes? Here you can say, for example, play trompo, play capirucho, yes, whatever. Next. Sing. 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 Paint. 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 Make pottery. Make pottery. Pottery is this. This is pottery, okay? People who make potter, who work clay, just make potter, yes? Next. Write. 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 Skateboard. 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 Fish. 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 Okay, so those are the most common leisure time activities that people usually do, okay? Dance, play chess, watch TV, play video games, read, play sports, play the guitar, sing, paint, make pottery, fish, skateboard, and write. Okay, those are the most common leisure time activities, all free time activities. Now, let's continue. Practice. Practice here. Al aprender un segundo idioma, es muy importante comprender y enriquecer nuestro vocabulario. Una forma fácil de aprenderlo es reconociendo las diferentes collocations, grupos de palabras que naturalmente suenan correctas y van siempre juntas. Attention, that's collocations. Those groups of words that always, always go together. Nunca se separan, siempre van juntas, ¿yes? ¿Has escuchado la palabra fast food? Fast food, para referirse a comida rápida. O las expresiones do homework, hacer tarea, y make the bed. Todas ellas son collocations, collocations. Y estos grupos de palabras no pueden ser sustituidos con otros verbos. Attention, no pueden ser sustituidos con otros verbos. They always go together, always go together. Siempre van juntos. En este ejercicio, tú nos ayudarás a colocar los verbos con los sustantivos correctos. Now you have the exercise here. You have to match the verb with the correct noun to form a leisure time activity collocation, okay? You have to match, unir, yes, this verb, el verbo, with the correct leisure time activities. So, for example, you get take a picture, or take a selfie, yes? You get do exercise, or do aerobics, yes? Do exercise, do aerobics. That's it. Another one. For example, sing a song. Here, those are the collocations. I'm going to show you a chart. Vamos a darle un cuadro. I'm going to show you a chart where you can see all the collocations, okay? Aquí están todas las collocations. You can see all the collocations over here, yes? You got, for example, take a picture, read a book, play a sport or a musical instrument, watch a movie or watch a TV show, yes? You sing a song, yes? Next is dance salsa, dance bachata, dance tango, yes? Write a blog, write a poem, write a story, yes? You have also go to the park, listen to music or listen to the radio. Do exercise or do aerobics, yes? Si se fijan aquí al final, there are two options. Hay dos opciones, yes? There are two options here. You can say, for example, take a picture, or you can say take a selfie, okay? Well, whatever, those are correct. You can say, for example, read a book, or you can also say read a magazine, yes? You can say to read a novel, yes? Also, you can say play a sport, play soccer, play basketball, play tennis, yes? Also, you can say play a musical instrument. For example, I was saying play the guitar, play the piano, yes? Play the trumpet, okay? Watch TV, for example, or watch a movie, yes? Watch a movie, watch TV, yes? Those are collocations. Now, I would like to show you something else. Quiero que te fijes en algo más. Here is a third person singular. Tercera persona al singular. He, she, it. He, she, it en Spanish es él, ella, eso. He, she, it. Okay? So, for example, si voy a decir yo, tú, nosotros o ellos, decimos, for example, in English, I take a picture. Yo tomo una foto. Or I take a selfie. That's correct, yes? Pero si vamos a decir que él lo hace, lo decimos así, mira, he takes. He takes. ¿Por qué? Porque en la tercera persona del singular, a todos los verbos les añadimos una S. Atención a lo que estoy diciendo. En la tercera persona del singular, a todos los verbos le añadimos una S. Mira, aquí tenemos él. He takes a selfie. He takes a selfie. ¿Ok? Con ella sería lo mismo. She takes a selfie. ¿Ok? La tercera persona del singular, a todos los verbos le añadimos una S. Si voy a hacerlo con otro, con I, you, we, they, no lleva la S. ¿Eh? Pero si lo voy a hacer con he, she o con it, ahí sí lleva la S. Y si te fijas, eso está en todo. Mira, en he, she, it, reads. He, she, it, plays. Y en cambio en los otros no la lleva, no la lleva, no la lleva. Attention to that, ¿ok? Porque así es como se usa la third person singular. Ahora, esto de he, she, it se puede sustituir. Lo borramos aquí. Yes, do we erase it over here? Y en vez de decir he, she, it, él, ella, eso, podemos sustituirlo con un nombre. For example, Thomas takes a picture. Thomas takes a selfie. Yes? Griselda reads a book. Griselda reads a novel, for example. Okay? Let's see another example. Gabby plays a sport. For example, you can say, Gabby plays soccer. Gabby plays the guitar, for example. Okay? Attention here. Al igual como Gabby es un she, ¿verdad? Es ella. Ahí lleva la S. Yes? Griselda también. Es a she, es una ella. Lleva la S, reads, ¿ok? Y si pay attention y si te fijas en todo lo que es tercera persona, en que es él o ella, he or she, lleva la S, ¿yes? Moses watches, attention here. Aquí no solo le añadimos S, le añadimos ES. Moses watches a movie, ¿yes? Michael sings, lleva la S. Michael sings a song, ¿yes? Alan dances, le añadimos S. Alan dances salsa, ok. Esther writes, escribe, Esther writes a blog or a poem or a story, ok. Daniela goes, attention, aquí le ponemos la E y la S, ¿eh? Daniela goes to the movies, yes. Rocío listens to music, ok. Maritza does aerobics. Ok, aquí le añadimos la E y la S. Ok, attention to this. Le pueden tomar screenshots. Take a screenshot of this, please. Para que sepan how to write the collocations correctly. Para que sepan cómo escribir las collocations correctly. Ok, y de nuevo, take a screenshot because you will use this chart. Le va a servir este chart in the next activity. Please take a screenshot now. Ok, take a screenshot here also. Ok. Screenshot here. Okay. This chart, ese cuadro, is going to be useful in the next activity. Lo va a servir en esta activity, que sería la última. Production. ¿Cuáles actividades realizan las siguientes personas en su tiempo libre? Attention here. Escribe oraciones en el presente. No olvides agregar una S al verbo, lo que estábamos diciendo. Yes, what we were saying. Respetando las reglas de la escritura. Analiza los ejemplos para una mejor orientación. Example. Carlos. Where is Carlos here? Carlos, 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 Carlos. Where do you see Carlos? There is Carlos. Yes? Carlos is working in a sewing machine. Está cosiendo. Yes? So, Carlos sews. Lleva la S. Mira, add the S. Carlos sews in his free time. Okay? Now we have Vilma. Where is Vilma? Vilma, Vilma, Vilma. Here is Vilma. Vilma is knitting. Yes, knitting means tejiendo. Okay, so Vilma, Vilma knits. See, la S, knits in her free time, okay? Lo mismo aquí. Janet reads in her free time, okay? Ramón, here we have Ramón, yes. Ramón makes, añadiendo la S, makes pottery, yes. Makes pottery. Recuerda estos examples. Makes pottery, los que vimos aquí, yes. Ramón makes pottery. Recuerda añadir la S, remember to add the S. Mercedes waters the plants, okay? Mercedes waters the plants, for example, yes? Now, Marlene does exercise, for example. Marlene does exercise, yes? And so on, okay? Escribimos una sentence, we write a sentence for each one of these people in the picture, okay? So that's it, eso sería todo. Again, if you have any questions, you can send me a personal WhatsApp. So, bye guys, see you around.